I think that Aubrey Mayer has done an amazing job and has shown extraordinary persistence and ingenuity in working out a scheme of this kind, and I very much admire him for it. Above all, he's laid out a kind of intellectual and legal framework, which is what we need if you're going to set global arrangements in place. It is not the time for half measures or quarter measures or fiddling with the problem. It's important to lay out the principles and then see how they should best be interpreted to give effect to a common human problem.
We only have maybe 1 to 2 decades to really tackle emissions. If we hang on any longer than that, then what's going to be a bad situation is going to become completely catastrophic. And I feel that contraction and convergence is really the only mechanism we have available that can solve this problem in time.
Well, I think if one looks at the kinds of reductions that would be required globally, I think the only means for doing so is to ensure that there's contraction and convergence. And I think there's growing acceptance of this reality, because I don't see how else we might be able to fit within the overall budget of emissions for the world as a whole by 2050. And we need to start putting this principle into practice as early as possible, so that by the time we reach 2050, we're not caught by surprise.
Aubrey is the director of the Global Commons Institute.
Music is really where I began and conducted my life until I was 40. And you don't think about this, but it's fundamentally about time management. You have to measure space, but also time, in respect of playing in tune and also playing in time. It inherently works because of its acute time dependency. The climate change problem so far has remained unaddressed in a realistic manner, because primarily the policy that has been brought to bear on it is seen as economic. We have in effect what you can call the double jeopardy of climate change. It is the increasingly asymmetric global development, where money and people go in two opposite directions. There are more and more poor people who are discards, while fewer and fewer people become more and more absurdly wealthy. It's a kind of global apartheid. We call this expansion and divergence. It grows on average at 3% per annum and has done for several decades, at least since the Second World War. The other problem, the other part of the double jeopardy, is the fact that the rate of damages caused by climate change against what the insurers called uninsured economic losses due to climate change is going at twice that rate. In other words, it's going at 6% per annum. Albeit from a lower base, it's only a matter of time before the rate of damages overwhelms the economy with all its asymmetries and makes all our future efforts completely irrelevant.
I think Aubrey is a good gentleman, because he has really been on this issue for years, you know, donkey years, and he's not giving up. And he has the stamina. I think if we were all of us like Aubrey, we would have achieved very high levels. Unfortunately, not many of us have been that strong.